Good morning, Big Spring. I'm Vince.
And I'm Tyler.
And this is your Channel 3 News. Attention current high school sophomores and juniors. Gettysburg College is offering exciting academic programs, summer camps in the following programs. Psychology, government and leadership, writing and civil war. Please see the summer program binder in the counseling office for more information.
The PA Institute for Conservation Education is offering wildlife leadership field schools for the summer. Concentrations in bucktail, brook trout, rough grouse, black bear are available.
Looking for something to read for SSR? Check out this book trailer brought to you by Bookends.
February 23rd through the 27th is National FFA Week. Help celebrate by participating in the following spirit days. Monday is Camouflage Day. Tuesday is Plaid Day. Wednesday, Bulldog Pride Day. Thursday is Cowboy Day. Friday is Blue and Gold Day. Go all out for National FFA Week. And now over to Anna with your weather.
Like I can, a chance encounter of circumstance. Maybe he's a mantra, put your mind in trance.
Hi, I'm Anna with your Channel 3 weather. There was a near record cold again this morning with wind chill values between negative 20 and negative 30, which is super cold. Another windstorm takes aim at the mid-Atlantic this weekend. This snowstorm now appears to be moving rather quickly, making it a Saturday event rather than Sunday. Expect snow to develop Saturday morning and continue steady at times through the daylight hours, but not when it's dark. By late Saturday evening, we expect 2 to 5 inches of snow before most locations and viewing area before a slushy mix of snow, sleet, and rain creates additional slushy accumulations overnight. This storm wraps up early Sunday morning before dawn. Now back to your news.
Do you like a nice sweet treat, Vince?
Why, yes, I do.
Well, the musical crew is hosting a Dairy Queen fundraiser next Tuesday. Check this out.
Get right on those sports sign-ups. Sign-ups for mini-thon sports tournaments will be going on during A and B lunches from now until March 10th. Tournaments include volleyball 6-on-6, up to 8 people on a team, dodgeball 6-to-6, 8 people on a team, and basketball 3-on-3, up to 5 people on a team. Make sure you have the first and last names of all of your players and a team name ready when you come down to the table to sign up.
Another great way to raise money for FTK is to buy mini-thon bracelets at lunch. At lunch, every single day, they're sold. Bracelets cost $2. Bracelets say FDK because no kid should fight alone. There are a variety of colors.
I will find my way. I can go the distance. I'll be there someday. If I can be strong, I know every mile will be worth my while. would go most anywhere to feel like I.
FDK! Woo!
Check out this story done on CBS 21 News, which features our very own Evan Moyer. And then hurry to get your Minithon donations so that you can help out as well.
I'm not doing well today.
Yeah,
I understand a lot.
Yeah.
Happening now, believe it or not, people are getting ready to run now in this run.
39 runners are trekking 135 miles from Hershey to Penn State University.
CBS 21's Jesse Knudsen live now with the runners. And Jesse, it's cold, but they're running for a good cause.
Absolutely live in time, live in Penn State Hershey Medical Center. We have runner coming right here, Jennifer. Her son is a sophomore at Penn State. He had leukemia, but in a fight against this, all for the kids, these runners are running 135 miles all the way up to State College.
In just 24 hours, one of the largest fundraisers in the country will kick off its big weekend. Penn State students, volunteers, and Four Diamonds families will join together for 46 hours straight of dancing as part of Thon Weekend. And this year, one local teen will be making his first trip to Thon after nearly a year of fighting cancer.
The doctors thought I had something wrong with me. They thought it was pneumonia.
That was in April of last year, and what 17-year-old Evan Moyer was told by doctors next is something he never thought he'd hear.
It ended up being a leukemia.
Evan had to spend weeks in the hospital before being released, but after months of battling, he's getting better.
Now I'm in maintenance, so I don't have to go back to the hospital as often.
Evan, now a senior in high school, says the support he's experienced through his leukemia has opened his eyes to a whole new world.
It's just amazing that people do what they do, and it's nice to know there are people out there that help.
Last week, Evan's classmates at Big Spring High School wore orange to support him, and this weekend, he'll experience an event tailored for people just like him. And through all of this, he's learned one thing.
Life is precious.
Alright, so these runners will be going along the roads, even though it's freezing out here, for 135 miles, and they're carrying runners from people here at the Children's Hospital all the way up there to say thank you, because of course, this is all for the kids. The thon is exactly 24 hours from now, and it's here to raise millions of dollars for kids with pediatric cancer. Reporting live from Gary Township, Jesse Knudsen, CBS 21 News.
I'm Vince.
And I'm Tyler.
And this is your Channel 3 News!
Woo!